I'm Lexi Coquillette, a Fresh Films intern from Jupiter, Florida. I had the wonderful opportunity to interview Jess Kender about her role as a production designer and wanted to share it with you. Okay, so like I said, I looked into your job a little bit, and I know it's amazing, but I'd like to hear from you a little about what your day-to-day is like, and maybe what projects are you currently working on?
Well, I'm currently working on Daisy Jones and the Six, which is with Hello Sunshine, and it is based on a book. And it's, I would say the book is loosely based off of Fleetwood Mac and Stevie Nicks. So it's 1970s, like rock LA, a little bit of disco in there. It's like the dream job with the dream company, you know, in the dream place. And as far as my day goes day to day, it is hard to actually say that because it's different every day, which is what's exciting about the job. If I was going to try and make a typical day, it would probably be something like I get up in the morning, I get to stage, I walk the sets to see how they're coming. I come back in the office. There's going to be some type of meeting. I'll be checking on the work everybody's done, looking at samples of, you know, carpet and paint and looking at a model of a set and redlining drawings. And then I'll probably be in the van for the next couple hours and we get to drive around and see everything from like mansions to, you know, the bowels of like Staples Center, you know, like traveling all over, and then come back maybe at the end of the day, maybe not. Maybe I'll go open a set, try and walk the stages again, go home. But it's so different every day. Like some days this week, there was one day that we were out scouting from 8:30 to 7:30. So that's all I did all day. You know, I love opening a set that I'm really excited about. Like if I have a set and I'm like, this set, this people are going to love this, you know, and like waiting to see the actors and the producers and the crew come on and like their response. That's probably my second favorite thing.
What kind of, I guess, personality traits did you notice growing up? Or maybe personality traits that really help you in this role?
Well, it's interesting. I think this role is a little different than what people think it is, because I often say that production design is like 90% people management and 10% design, because I have this design in my head and I have to figure out a way for both my producers and my directors, you know, and sometimes my actors to agree that what I see is the right thing. And then I have to get all the different departments I work with to also see that same vision and figure out how we're going to do it on budget, on time, you know, all those things. So it actually, growing up, I was always into art, you know, like always drew. I did stage crew in high school, you know, like it was something that I loved to do. So you think getting into this job, you're like, oh, I love to do art. This is it. But I think your people skills, that is really one of the things that's almost, I would almost say a little more important. I don't have to be the best designer out there. I have to be ideally really good at my job, but I need to be even better at like dealing with people. My position is in charge of the art department, construction, set deck, props, locations. Those are just like those, I supervise all those departments. Then I also work with visual effects. I work with special effects, you know, like I need to work with the grips and electric. I work with the director. I work with all the producers. So really this job, again, goes back to the people management, all of those people I'm working with all of the time.
How did you first start in set design and then transition into production design?
So I did stage crew in high school. I worked 2 years in New York painting. So I painted on and off Broadway. I came out here and I started working in different like painting theme parks and doing a lot of like models for like game shows and stuff like that. And I got a job on the original Spider-Man as a PA in the art department.
Oh, that is so cool.
Oh, it was great. Like, it's so funny. So this is just a little side note. I have flames on my car. I've had the car for 16 years. I have to get rid of it. I'm getting a new car. I'm putting flames on the car. The original Green Goblin thing that they like, he flew on is this paint that goes from green to purple. And it was when that paint had first come out. It was one of the first samples I got on the job. And I just wrote the guy who's going to put the flames on my car and was like, can I use that paint on it? Can I do the, yeah. But so I got my first PA job on Spider-Man. And the way it worked in Sony was the art department was on this big U-shaped floor and TV was on one side. Movies were on the other side. And one of the guy who's working on a TV show would always come over and like nibble off at our craft service. Mm-hmm. And we would start chatting and I would be like, you know, I really want a set design, you know, this and that. And it just happened, his set designer was leaving and the list was really low. And because we had spent 6 months chatting over like pastries, he helped get me in the union. So I got my first set design job that way. Yeah. And then my second, I moved up pretty quickly. Like I got my first production design when I was 28. I had been on a pilot as an art director and they wanted that designer back. That designer took another show. They came to me and said, can you recommend other people? And everyone I liked was working. And I was like, I don't want to be pushed on anyone else. You know, like that never works out. Mm-hmm. And they said, okay, don't take any other jobs. I'll call you back in a day. And they called me back and said, we want you to do the show. I know it was nuts. I called my husband that night and I was like, they offered me the show. And his response was, what? So, and then they were like, okay, put together your team. And I was like, I don't have a team. Okay.
Working when you're first working on a set, is the process like of turning the visuals to the actual set?
You know, for me, it actually starts with when I read a script. Like mm-hmm. when I read a script, as I read, I start to see it in my head, what I think it should be, mm-hmm. especially a script that really speaks to me. It's very easy. Like, I think it's the same as when most people read a book, you know, like, especially if, let's say you're a director, you're character driven, you know, like you can see that person in your head. For me, I see the sets as I read. Mm-hmm. And then it's a matter of me pulling research that fits what I have in my mind. So I have this idea and I try and pull research so I can show it to the people who aren't in my head. Or I'll try and sort of explain it to my art department. I'm sort of thinking this, I like this vibe, pull research for me, because maybe what you find is gonna add to what I already have in my head. I shouldn't say maybe, always adds to what I have in my head. You know, like I think art, I am a much better designer when the people that I work with add their own take onto things because it makes things much more interesting. And it depends if we're doing permanent sets, I'll usually do like a 3D walkthrough, white model, you know, like maybe I'll have some fabric samples, maybe I'll have some color samples. As I get into the show, if I have the trust of the producers, I don't normally need to show them all that information because at that point they're like, you get what we were trying to say. Go ahead and just do your job.
What kind of sets are you hoping to create in the future?
I think right now I'm actually at a point in my career where the people I work with are as equally as important as the shows that I do. I tend to actually love the 70s forward. Like those are my favorite periods to work on. So this is perfect for me. But I would take anything that I haven't really done before would be exciting. Or if I get to do it in a new take, you know, like Little Fires was interesting because I got to do the 90s. Like that was super fun. I would do another 90s show if it was out there and maybe it addressed other things. So I'd be showing a different part of the 90s. I'd like to play with stuff I haven't done before, mm-hmm. but I would easily play with stuff I've done before if it was for people I loved.
Okay.
I think both are equally important because both can be incredibly satisfying. And then sometimes you get a dream job where you get to have both at once.
What is something you could tell me about one of your favorite projects?
You know, it's so funny. I think I'm lucky enough that almost all of my projects at the time I'm working on them are my favorites. Mm-hmm. However, now that I am, so I'm 45. Mm-hmm. Now that I am in my 40s, I'm at a position where I'm starting to realize, like, my mom worked, you know, she kept her last name. She did all of those things. And for years, she basically would talk to me about how, like, you have to understand that in the workplace, like, you are fighting a battle for equality. I think as I was in my 30s, you're just fighting to be noticed. You know, you're fighting to show I'm a quality designer. You know, like, I can do this job. I can play in this playground. Like, look at me. Mm-hmm. I feel like I'm established enough now that I can be somebody who helps move forward the industry into a place that I want to work in more. You know, one of the things that's great about Hello Sunshine is it's so female forward. And in my 30s, I didn't notice the inequalities as much, you know, like, I didn't see that. But in my 40s, I see it more and I can change that. And so my dream job is a job where I'm working with like-minded people and I'm able to sort of reshape our industry together. So that for me, it's less so about almost the design of it, but like where I'm taking this job that I do and this industry we work in. Like, how can I change that? How can I be a part of this?
I didn't know anything about this career in film until meeting Jess and hearing about what she does on a film set. I learned that this role has so many different aspects to it, and that the visuals of a film or series depend on a great production designer to help communicate the director's vision. I learned that a production designer's role is just as much about communication and leadership as it is art and design. Finally, one of Jess's pieces of advice that resonated with me most is that if you're passionate about an area of film, go after it. Her passion and knowledge for what she does is inspiring to any young filmmaker. If you want to hear from more industry professionals, please subscribe to our channel to watch more episodes from our Fresh Films Industry Insight series.